Hello, everyone, and welcome to the series where we are going to speak about how to approach your child and their sexuality. So welcome, Chanel. How are you?
Thank you very much. I am great and very excited about this topic, and I feel very privileged that you chose me to share a screen with you. It's an honor, and I'm extremely excited for what is going to happen from this series.
Yes, so let's dive right in. So today we're going to discuss about how do we open the subject of sexuality with kids as young as 0 to 2 years old? So please share your wisdom with us.
Awesome. This is normally a stage where parents think, oh no, my child is way too young. I can't start thinking about their sexuality or how to approach them. But this is the exact right time. I want to use the analogy of a thunderstorm that comes down and it's just destruction, and there's a flood and the house's foundation is shaken. And that's what happens if we as parents have a mindset that we have to have this one-time talk with our kids. Instead, I want to give you this vision of a constant soft rain that keeps on raining down on our kids throughout their lives, even as young as in the age bracket of 0 to 2 years old. We have this mindset. We are going to keep the conversation open when we speak to our children about their sexuality. And it starts as simple as just when your 18-month-old runs to you and you just grab them up in your arms and you swing them around and you say, oh, I'm so thankful that God made you a boy. I've always wanted a boy just like you. And then we are truly fixing them and making them steadfast in that reality that God designed them. He had a specific purpose for them as a boy. It can also be as simple as while you're busy bathing them or dressing them and just saying, God made you a boy, God made mommy a girl, and daddy is a boy, and you two look alike. And you can already start putting that foundation there that you are designed a specific sex for a specific reason on earth, from a young age, such as 2 years old.
Yeah. And I think in previous discussions that we've had, Chanel, is that you've said that just the basics that the child need are feeling secure, feeling loved, feeling at home in a family is also a great foundation that is laid in terms of their sexuality.
Definitely. When you know that you are wanted just the way you are, you don't have to change something. Mm-hmm. Nothing is wrong with you. God designed you like this, and we welcome you into our family structure for the way that you are. Then there's a sense of security that later in life, you don't go and look for and search for in different relationships, specifically in the teen years, where you know, this is my foundation. Even if I'm not accepted amongst my peers or at school, or even in the extended family, in my immediate family, I am accepted the way God designed me, even if I've got different interests. And that's a very important fact that we need to consider later in our child's development, is an interest does not mean that your child is sexually different, homosexual or gay or whatever. We'll speak about all of that. It's just an interest, and that starts when they're 2 years old. Even if your little boy likes to play with his sister's dolls, it's okay. It's a fantastic pediatrician in the making. Let's embrace who our children are and give them that security that they so deeply need.
I think this is really a foundation phase for identity and building our children's self-esteem. And identity and self-esteem has such a big role in sexuality, because when you know that you are loved, when you know that you are accepted, it obviously goes hand in hand. And it's much easier when you turn to God, that you know that you are loved and you know that you are accepted, then later in life, it is less likely for children then to grab on to other places and find acceptance and love in other places. But let's just move to the practical. Okay, so if we want to lay this foundation, Chanel, how do we just do it for 0 to 2 years old? I mean, they are really still small.
They are very small. And I think the biggest challenge is the lack of communication in the age bracket of 0 to 2. Therefore, the parents are, you are the main source of communication. You speak to your child, and it's kind of the easiest phase because they don't have the awkward questions that catch you off guard, but you need to do the talking. So let's speak practical about, let's say, for example, what do you name the specific areas of the child's body? Okay, so you come and you say, oh, God gave you hair. Let's touch our hair. And you stand in front of a mirror and say, okay, let's name the body parts of our body. And you do the narrative. And you as the parents say, this is our hair. This is our cheeks. This is our shoulders. Even at that age, you can use nicknames. You can say whatever you want to call the genital areas. You can say, okay, this is a paraki, this is a cookie, whatever you want to call it. You can lay that foundation. And I have a little boy and we call it a totterman. So or a totti. So you can call it that. It's okay. Get over yourself and say it's fine. We don't want our children to have this island mentality in their mind that my genital areas is somewhere apart from my body. And that starts with, like you said, Lene, it starts with body image. And then you can build on that. Every once in a while, maybe once a month, when you've got all of the courage together, you say, okay, you wash him and you say, okay, let's wash Totterman, or you call it a penis. And then you just carry on. Nonchalantly, you carry on. And you act like it's the most normal thing in the world, and you carry on.
So Chanel, what you're saying, you know, carrying nonchalantly, this is a big thing for parents, is that actually this time, early in the years of our children, we need to change our mind about sexuality. Because I think often the thing is not, you know, we are giving people practical tips, but that's not always the big question of, you know, practically how to handle it. It is, people don't know how to handle it because they feel uncomfortable. And when we know that sex and a healthy view of sexuality is from God. I mean, this is the way that God made us. if we can really get our minds and wrap our minds around that, it is much easier to even introduce this at the early age and speak to our children about this. Just another thing that I want to mention, you say, you know, giving special names to the genital parts, is that oftentimes we grew up in an era where we were not allowed to touch our genitals, you know, don't touch it. Yes, sis man. And I think this is something that we need to change. It is just part of the body. From 0 to 2 years, there is no wrong intention from a child when they are touching their vagina or their penis. It is really just exploring their bodies. And this is an explorative phase, and to keep them from having this weird mentality of their genitals or about sexuality, this is a very good phase to be actually as nonchalant as possible.
Definitely. And I really love the approach that we are going in with this, is because it is helping it to be normal. I'm not saying that in public we also set those boundaries, because that's what parents fear, is if I allow them to touch their genitals, then I'm going to be put on the spot somewhere in SPAR. And it's absolutely not that. When you have a healthy view of your sexuality, then you know that it is private, but it is not evil. It's not dirty. And it's not wrong. And that is a fix that we need to do as adults later. If in our growing up years, our parents did not approach it correctly, then in our marriage, we need to fix this mindset of it is good and it's godly and it's not evil. So definitely, Lene, you would allow your child to touch themselves and just go about it as cool and calmly as you can and say, yes, God made you a boy and you've got special tools. You are so amazing and I'm so glad that God designed you this way. Once again, give them that foundation that you are accepted, everything, your whole the way that you are. The fear of it's going to go excessive, you will find that if you allow them in the explorative phase to just explore, they will not go overboard.
Yes. And I think you've touched on privacy also, which is also something that I've seen with my children. Though they don't grasp it yet, it is definitely something I already introduced before 2 years old. Like, for example, my children wants to touch my boobs. Mm-hmm. So if there are people here, then I say it out loud. I just say, you cannot touch my boobies when there are other people here, you know, because it is private for mom. So just on a last note, Chanel, how do we introduce that God has made you the way you are? How do we do that?
I would definitely involve God in everything in our children's lives, not just with regard to their sexuality, but in everything. When we make decisions about where to go on holiday, it becomes a way of life. Once again, referring back to the analogy of the soft rain, it becomes a way of life. So God is a part of everything. When we eat, we pray. When we drive, we pray. When we bath, we discuss how wonderful God made us. And in this phase, it is their bodies is closest to them. And that is going to be your winning tool, is to use their bodies and to speak to them about how God designed each one's eye color differently, and how God designed you a boy and you a girl, and these are the basic differences, biological differences, and even maybe personality differences, and it is okay to be different for who you are, and we embrace the design that God had with you. So to not make it an awkward moment of, okay, God made you this way, but to really speak about it even while they're busy climbing a tree. Say, oh, it's so precious for me to see how your sister is climbing here on the safe side, and she maybe likes to play on the chairs and so, but God made you a boy and he gave you courage, and there you're going up the tree. And then we connect the dots, that there's a specific design that God made for each and every one of us, and our uniqueness is special to God. I just would like to add a little something just before we end off. What you just spoke about, when your children wants to touch your boobies in front of someone, is it's important to lay the boundaries in this phase.
Yeah.
0 to 2 years old, yeah. Boundaries is your key word with your children, not just with regard to their sexuality, but everything. They are testing the boundaries. When they are very, very young, they're testing the boundaries. Is it safe for me to trust my parents? And they've got the boundaries in place. And then when they get a little bit older, they continue pushing the boundaries, even closer to 2 years, we get into the terrible twos, and we know, oh goodness, I like to call it the terrific twos, but anyways, and we get to the 2 year olds, and then we need to put the boundaries in place there and say, when we are behind closed doors in the bathroom, while we're bathing and while we're busy dressing, these are the boundaries where it is acceptable. And we need to teach our children what is acceptable and what is not. And we've spoken about this during this session, is you need to get your head right and you need to be comfortable with your body in front of your children so that they see that I am accepted and these are acceptable behaviors behind closed doors and then when we are in public.
Thank you, Chanel. I think just as a last note, what it also just pops up, we've been speaking about body image being the foundation. And for me, body image is such an important part of self-esteem. So what I also tell my children is that you are beautiful inside and out, so that they know that God has made them the way they are, personality-wise, like you said, but also outside. And I think especially with girls, you know, I've heard stories of girls 4 and 5 years old already being on diet, for example, or, you know, saying they don't like something about our bodies. And I think as parents, it is our role to tell our children from a young age that you are beautiful inside and out, so that they know, you know, your body is not your enemy. Your body, God gave your body to you. So, and that they can have that healthy view of themselves. Thank you for your time. And this is just a short video, but we're going to next week then continue with the next age group. Thank you, Chanel.
You are welcome. And bye-bye. It was an honor to serve with you. Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye.